VFDs are a common way to improve the efficiency and performance of induction motors in most applications. However, it's not always practical to use a VFD for each motor in the system. In this video, we'll be talking about how we can use one VFD to power multiple induction motors. Typically, induction motors are controlled in one of two ways. The first is line feeding the motors. When motors are line fed, three-phase electricity is fed directly into the motor, and it's controlled with on-off contactors. This offers a simple solution because the motors are controlled on or off. However, there's no control over the speed with this system. Also, when the motors are turned on, there's a very high inrush current. The other common way to control induction motors is using one VFD per motor. With this solution, you have full speed control over the motor. So for example, you can run at full speed, half speed, any speed that the application demands. Along with that, you have full control over the acceleration and deceleration. So you have smooth startups to prevent the high inrush current that's present with line feeding the motors. In addition, you also have several protection features that are offered by the VFD. For example, direct temperature monitoring of the motors. However, it's not always practical to use separate VFDs for every motor. Here we'll talk about how we can use one VFD to drive multiple motors at once. To achieve this kind of setup, all of the motor leads coming out of each individual motor would be connected onto one common point. This can be then routed through the UVW output coming out of the drive. We would also have to add some individual overload protection for each motor, because the drive doesn't have a way to detect the individual motor temperature of each motor. Now that all the motors are connected to the drive can give a speed command and control all the motors in unison. As the drive ramps up the speed, all the motors will ramp up together. As the drive ramps down the speed, they'll all decelerate at the same time. There are some key considerations when going with this kind of setup. For example, multiple motors can only be run with one VFD when the motors are induction motors. This could not be done with servos because servos require the waveform to track with where the rotor position is. However, induction motors have some slip. So even if one motor gets bogged down with load, it won't lose track from where the waveform is while it's running. Also, the system should be run in volts-hertz, or open loop. Volts-hertz allows the drive to output the same voltage and frequency for all the motors in the system. This means that the drive doesn't have to take into account the rotor position of each individual motor. It just outputs a blind waveform to all the motors. When sizing a VFD for this system, it's important to take into account the combined full load amperage of all the motors in the system. For example, if you have two motors, each being rated for 10 amps, you would want to size the drive for at least 20 amps. It's also a good idea to size the drive with at least 125% overhead, just to take into account the worst case scenario. Using multiple motors driven from one VFD lends itself to applications that don't require precise speed control, but you also still want to vary the speed depending on the load. For example, some applications might include conveyors, pumps, or fans. Using one VFD to drive multiple motors is a very simple and cost-effective solution for applications where using multiple VFDs isn't practical. By understanding key considerations and ideal use cases, this type of setup optimizes space and efficiency. Also, we can avoid the high inrush currents present with line feeding because we have full control over the speed. If you'd like to learn more, feel free to reach out to us at KEB America.